Spooky cat. Andrew, one of my undergraduate friends, had this experience when he was just 12 years old. Andrew's family was likewise wealthy at the time. Despite the fact that they lived in the country, their lives were rather comfortable. There was a peculiar black cat in the narrative. Andrew was awakened by a wail that sounded like a baby crying on a hot summer night. Andrew crept closer to the glass to see what was causing the commotion. Both Mum and Dad were soundly asleep around him. Andrew took a look out the window. A black cat was on the roof of his grandfather's house, which was across the street. When he had a closer look, he noticed something peculiar. Because the black cat was standing on its hind legs as if it were a human, and behaving weirdly and perplexingly. The cat appeared to be dancing. The cat's eyes suddenly glowed with a ghostly blue light. His mouth was filled with sad moans that were both harsh and frightening. Andrew couldn't do anything because he was too young to understand what he was doing, so all he could do was stand still and gaze longingly out the window. The black cat continued to dance as if it were praying for something, which reminded me of shamanic rites we'd seen in movies. Andrew's line of thinking was abruptly interrupted by a voice. When he turned around, he noticed his mother. She chastised Andrew because it was past midnight and he still hadn't slept. Andrew suddenly remembered the black cat after hearing his mother lamented. So he tried to see over the other side of the house to see if the black cat was still dancing. But, perhaps hearing Andrew and his mother's voices, the cat paused on his 2 feet and cast a gaze at Andrew with those blue eyes. Then he leapt away and vanished. Andrew hastily returned to his bed to continue sleeping, fearful that his mother would be concerned. Andrew's mother was likewise curious as to what Andrew was staring at outside the window at midnight. Everything was great the next morning. Andrew also forgot about the previous night's events. Andrew had intended to play with the local youngsters after lunch. Something attracted his attention. It had been the black cat the night before. Andrew quickly remembered everything unusual he'd seen. The black cat was sunbathing on the wall, much like other cats. He opened his eyes to glance at Andrew after hearing the sound. Then he swung around to sleep in the opposite direction. Andrew received the impression that the cat was grumpy because Andrew had bothered him the night before. Andrew, on the other hand, was youthful and didn't seem to mind. Andrew's family has experienced something unexpected and heartbreaking up until that night. His granddad died after suffering a stroke. It was too late by the time he was taken to the hospital. The doctor also determined that the grandfather could no longer be treated, therefore he requested that Andrew's family take him home. The family gathered as soon as possible to bid him farewell. Because of Andrew's grandfather's unexpected death, everyone was heartbroken and sobbed a lot. He was normally very healthy and free of illness, but he died so quickly. Andrew is depressed as well. He wept a lot. He had almost forgotten about the cat that had danced on his grandpa's roof the night before. The meow of a cat suddenly drew Andrew's attention. The funny thing is that there were a lot of people present at the time, but no one heard the cat. Maybe they didn't care because everyone was crying about the tragedy. Andrew, on the other hand, was the one who heard it the most clearly. He dashed over to the glass door and put his face against it, curious as to what the black cat was up to. Andrew noticed a little black cat guiding someone behind him on the dark and twisting country road outside. He couldn't see who was there because it was too dark. The cat continued to shriek and led the way. Andrew dashed out into the yard, turning on the front light to see who the black cat was leading, unsure what to do next. Andrew was taken aback by what he saw as he turned on the light in front of the house. Under the moonlight and the light that Andrew had just opened, he could clearly see the man's outline as the murky shadow approached. The black cat continued to walk slowly and look back. The cat appeared to be urging the man to speed up. Because that man was Andrew's grandfather, Andrew's eyes widened in amazement. He had apparently died, and his body remained inside the house. How did he manage to show up out here? He yelled for everyone to leave. He claimed that his grandfather had returned and that the cat had returned him to his family. Inside, everyone gathered to mourn the grandfather's death. They were surprised when they heard Andrew's shouts and turned their heads to the door. Concerned about what had happened to Andrew, the family members panicked and rushed out into the yard to investigate. Outside, Andrew stood. Grandpa had returned, he remarked casually. He pointed to the black cat and stated emphatically that the cat was the one who guided him back to his family. Everyone gathered around the cat, but all they saw was a little black animal. As a result, they assumed Andrew was fabricating stories to make fun of the family. Andrew's father chastised him for making up stories in the middle of his sadness. The family then went back inside silently. Andrew, who was perplexed, was left behind. Andrew rubbed his temples. He stared at the black cat next to him in a daze. The animal returned his stare. Andrew then realized that he might have been completely mistaken. A scream came from within the home as he was thinking. It was Andrew's father who spoke. Even Andrew, who was standing in the yard, was frightened by the screams, which were so loud and desperate. Andrew rushed inside the home to see what had made his father cry in terror. Andrew noticed his father seated on the floor, shaking with terror, as soon as he opened the door. Andrew glanced up and screamed, much more terrified than his father. Because the grandfather's body was able to sit up regularly in bed, everyone in the family was startled and fell to the floor. Andrew's grandpa did not appear to be a ghost because he sat up and coughed dryly. His skin had returned to its typical rosiness. The entire family became less frightened after seeing this. Everyone gradually drew closer to him. They were curious and had a lot of questions. They weren't sure whether he was still alive or not. What they had witnessed was strange, almost unbelievable. How could he be miraculously revived after the hospital declared his death and his body grew pale and cold? When he touched the body, it was really incredibly warm. People felt he was still alive at the time. Andrew's mother, too, was overcome with excitement. The first inquiry he asked after he stopped coughing was about the black cat, not about his family. No one knew what he was talking about when he stated it had taken him home. Despite everyone's protestations, he hurriedly got out of bed and insisted on seeking the black cat despite his frail health. Andrew was the only one who understood what he was saying. He cast a peek around the yard, recalling the black cat that had been loitering outside. Andrew dashed out into the yard, realizing that the cat had been aware of his grandfather's death the previous night. The cat had been pleading for something to aid his grandfather with a weird dance. Andrew looked around but couldn't spot the black cat. In the years that followed, he did not see the cat again. Andrew understood later in life that the figure he saw that night was his grandfather's soul. His grandfather also stated that he had been caring for the stray cat for some years before the incident.